I am reminded of this comic strip by Johnny Hart, yung DC, about cavemen and dinosaurs and other animals who have philosophical views of life in the prehistoric era. Patapako nung nababasa ko ito, paborito kong comic strip kasi ito. And there's this one particular strip, hindi yan. Pero there's this one particular strip that tells about an anteater who began his ruminations about its being an anteater. He stalks an ant and then asks the existential question, why do I do it? For all we know, he says, he may even hate ants. But then, kasi one day, without anything better to do, he ate this one ant, and the human being saw it, and assigned him the name of an anteater. And from then on, anteater na siya. He assesses his existential condition and comes to the conclusion, you eat one lousy ant, and you're tight for life. So many times, ako din, I question my identity as a writer. The first time I was told I'm a playwright or something to that effect was during my first ever theater training at PETA in the short summer teen theater workshop in 1976. Doon pa lang, kasama na ako sa writer's pool ng class. And somehow, that's stuck in the minds of people from PETA when I became a regular member. And at first, I loved the label. Feeling ko, kasi mataas ang tingin sa'yo eh, kay writer. So, I also stayed with the writer's pool. We were divided into artistic pools then. In 1977, I enrolled in another workshop, the first and last clean playwriting workshop PETA has ever offered. Pero doon, hindi maganda yung output na nasmelt ko, and that was the beginning of so many stumbling blocks for me as a writer. Wala kasi akong formal training, workshop lang. And they didn't offer playwriting courses in college. It be that yes, the label people assigned to me may be true. I am a writer, but not a good one. Masakit. What do you expect I would do? Mahilig akong magmoy-moy sa kwarto ko noon. Hindi ako magaling, sabi ko minsan. When I saw the movie Amadeus, I related so much to the character of Salieri. I cried. Minsan, I walked along Rizal Avenue kasi malakap na nakatira. I remember walking faster and faster, parang may humahabol sa akin. That was the time when Lino said that this play does not deserve to be performed. You have to earn the right to perform plays at the Ras Suleiman, which is the stage of PETA before. And this one failed, sabi niya. Halos sumatakbo na ako noon. Wala naman talaga taong humahabol sa akin. I guess I was really running away from mediocrity. That was the one of the lowest moments of my life as a writer. I guess that's the most dreadful thing an artist could ever feel. Because if you can't be decent enough an artist, why the hell should you be one in the first place? From then on, and for a long time, I resisted being called a playwright. When PETA would ask me to write this or adapt that play, a part of me would say, are you sure? So when did I start believing that I'm a writer? Relatively recently. Actually, up until about 1992, I found a way of not claiming I am a writer. I always say, oh, I write. I just write, you know. As if I just Google or write something, by the way. It's not a profession. It's not a label, so it's more comfortable. It's not an identity I have to live up to. As far as I can remember, that was the time, 1992, I won my first literary award. Medyo late bloomer na kung sa department na yan. I was 32. De La Paz at si Rene Villanueva, sila yung mga writer. Why? Because they claimed it. They say it without batting an eyelash. With definite assuredness. Eh ako noon, parang hindi. Kasi nga, apart from my insecurities, I also sing and I dabble in acting, performing. There's this vague sense of expectation. That if you really, really want to say you are, say, writer na nga, then it's almost like you don't do anything else by profession. All the rest, you just do during your break time. Kung kakanta ka, saka okay lang. Paglasingan lang. Kasi you're supposed to have no other preoccupation but writing. Yun ang real writer, genuine, full-blooded, manunulat. But it got me into thinking, kung wala ba akong ibang inclination, would I have been compelled to accept my being a writer earlier on? Kung wala akong ibang ginagawa, because I was artistic director of this music group for quite a few years, and then also the director of a theater company for about 3 years. If I hadn't had those responsibilities or other abilities, would I have been just comfortable being regarded as a writer? Or would I have been compelled to cling to that label until some child critic will shout and say, that writer has no codes? Because back then, while they did recognize I had written plays, some people, without them saying it, seemed to suggest that I'm a better singer. Invited rather frequently to act in Singapore and Japan and New York, people didn't realize I wrote plays. Or maybe they had a vague idea, but they figured I must have done that as an aside. Samantalang dito sa atin, I would secretly love to perform on stage for a production, but nobody would consider me kasi I'm then known more as a writer na. Around 2003 na yon, takot ako sa mga audition, ayoko nung nag-audition din. Nangangatog ako, natutuyo na lang muna ko. I remember auditioning for Miss Saigon way back in the 80s, all that semifinals na nagdag. And then a couple of years after, Toronto production, pinagsayaw ako. Eh wala na, sabi ko, pang-text na lang ako noon. Kaya noong 2000, sabi ko, pipili ako at pinili ko, huwag na muna magtrabaho sa labas ng bansa. So like magic, nawala lahat ng offer of role, which means I chose, finally, to be a writer. So my identity as a writer became definite because I decided to become one no matter what the risk, at the risk of not being regarded as any other, but I claim to be one, you know, just like what a lawyer or a doctor does when she swears an oath to her profession. And soon enough, pakonti na lang pakonti ang mga acting tasks ko, which, of course, on the other hand, I nami-miss ko din. This time, I didn't just get caught eating an ant. I resolved to be an anteater. Para sa akin, tama si Chino Toledo, this composer and musician, a friend of mine. When we asked him, as a musician, how does he get the inspiration? And he said, alam niyo, bilang isang musician, I have learned to treat my craft like a real profession. It's not just about inspiration any longer. Inspiration is fleeting, it comes, it goes. Inspiration is triggered by practically anything. For instance, a memory. A Madeleine dipped in a cup of tea. Marcel Proust. Inspiration opens up a host of emotions and sensations. But here's the thing. Inspiration may or may not provoke you to write at all. It could provoke you to dance. The minute I assumed it was work as a playwright, I realized I have to be able to say, this is work, and I love my work. Which is why we are spelled that way. We don't just write, we build, we work. And the word write in playwright has a hint of muscle work to it, diba? Meaning hindi lang binubuo ang dula, binubuno din. The etymologies of the word writer and playwright come from two different sources. Writer comes from the old English word written to form letters. The write in playwright comes from the word yelta, shaper of wood, which virtually means the work of a carpenter. To build, in a sense that shipwrights build ships, millwrights construct machinery. Some scholars believe that it was Ben Jonson who coined the word playwright for no other reason than to insult people who built plays instead of writing them. And that is to differentiate playwrights from poets who wrote. Back then, hindi naman playwright ang tawag sa mga nagsusulat ng play, they were poets. Ay, nung panahon ni Aeschylus. And Ben Jonson considered himself a poet, which is why his plays were written in rhyme and meter. And ang implication, kapag hindi ka magaling na poet, you were a playwright. Ouch! So this is exactly what the poets told Neri Lebeva when he was a member of Galian's Arte at Dula way back in the 70s, when he wanted so much to be a poet. Alam mo, pagsulat ka na lang ng Dula, yun ang sabi na nila sa kanya. And then he did, and became one of the best playwrights of his generation. Kinikilala ng maraming playwrights ngayon as their mentor. Pero hindi po yan. So sabi ko, ito nga ba magiging identity ko? Magiging playwright na nga ako? By 1997, that's when I decided to declare to the world that okay, I'll be a playwright. It wasn't a literal declaration. Ako lang yun sa loob ng kwarto ko. Right before pumanong si Charlie de la Paz, I performed in his last opera for PETA, the musical 1896, Isang Manunulat. ako yung ano, anong klaseng manunulat ako. Mas pasiguro ito yung napupuntang yung issue sa pagpubuo ng aking identidad. Kapag ako yung susulat, kahit nung nagsisimula pa lang akong magsulat, hindi ko may waksi ang, and I use this cliche term, maging socially relevant. Does this have something to do with the continuing dichotomy of playwriting and poetry? I wonder, kasi si Bertolt Brecht would always say that. He too wrote poems, and he had left a huge volume of poems. Pero he hardly declared himself a poet. For him, his poetry was more personal, while his plays were more public, and hence, political. If I begin to interpret that, ako bilang mandudula, mas iniisip ang sarili bilang nakaharap sa manunulat with something to say, and I guess, intrinsically, hindi maiwasang maging political. Pero kung bilang poet, and I'm channeling Bertolt Brecht, mas iniisip ang sarili sa loob ng aking closet, walang nanonood. I guess that is why plays tend to be more political, kahit hindi ganun ka-manifest, kahit subtle. It will decidedly have to mention, tackle, deal with the social, the political. Why? Kasi nga, sabi ni Greg, public, therefore, social. Whether revolution yan, or sex, or religion, or kahit ano pang kausapan, parang hindi maiwasan. Pero ako lang siguro yun. Siguro dahil lumaki ako sa isang lipunan, ano man ang gawin mo, may sense of urgency. Panahon yun, ano? Hindi ko makita ang sumusulat ako ng hindi natatalakay ang politika ng isang bagay. Pero dahil ako yung aktivista noon, lalo itong kina-obvious, but also at one time, like most cultural workers of my generation, nagsawalin ako sa sobrang political. Para bang wala na magpapaksa, mag-ibig, little prince. And yet, I know deep inside me, lalaylay siya kung hindi nakatungon sa lipunan yung aking dula. Kahit pa little brain siguro, iya-adapt ko yun. May gustong sabihin sa lipunan. So, my identity as a writer, I shaped for myself. Which is probably the same way I shaped my identity as a Filipino. Maraming nagsasabi ngayon na nationality is a myth, an imagined notion. Which I agree, that is true. But we imagine everything naman, di ba? We imagine ourselves as Filipinos, as a nation. Yung boundaries noon, yung parameters, yung ibig sabihin noon, we claim it, we turn it into a right. Imagine ang ating community, if I may paraphrase Benedict Anderson. Pero sabi rin ni Gemino Abad, in his brilliant essay, The Poem is What You Will, what is most real is what is most imagined. Question number two, may pera ba sa pagsusulat? Ang tanong na ito reminds me of the ad, may pera sa basura. You can take that literally and figuratively. That means you can push the money motive to the hilt. I will not judge you. Ang totoo niyan, I will envy you in a way. Lalo na kung meron akong gustong bilhin at hindi mo bilhin kasi hindi mo lang kumikita ng malaki. At pwede kang kumita ng malaki sa pagsusulat. Noong dinitara kong ako yung writer, nagpasya na rin akong i-push ang pagiging writer ko as a profession. Ang sabi ko sa sarili ko, kung maging writer na rin ako, eh dapat ito lang maging main source of income ko. Subukan ko lang, kasi maraming mga writers ang hindi yun yung main job nila. It's not like an accountant, or a lawyer, or a doctor. Kasi hindi man ako yung tapos ng kolehiyo, so hindi ako pwede maging teacher. Nagawa ko ba? Yes and no. Kung dula lang ang pagbabasihan ng source ko ng income, definitely no. Although, that may change in the next few years. At para sa mga nag-playwriting course. Because there is among huge real estate companies a sudden interest to build theaters. And I mean theaters for live shows. Some of them are even designed for theaters in performance of play. So, does it pay to be a playwright? You want figures? The current normal rates for playwrights in the Philippines range from 10,000 to 150,000. 10,000 to 25,000 kung one act. Huwag ka lang sisingit ang mas mababa doon. Kung ang nalong. Pero, pwede pa rin tumawa, lalo na kung school production. Kung full length, pwede from 20 to 150. Kung nga, kung 200. Depende kung sino gagawa. The usual practice is, playwright is occasioned to write a play, or may have pitched something that got a lot of interest from the producer or the company, although pitching is not really a practice yet. He is paid this sum, which is equivalent to a certain number of shows or a period of years, say mga 30 shows, may iba tatawag ng 40 shows, after which the playwright gets royalty fee per show, ranging from 2K to 5K, depending on hit bayan, or overall production budget per show, or audience capacity ng theater. The royalty practice is para sa publication, I imagine, or sa recording industry. A play that has run for around 100 to 200 shows is already a certified hit. Normally, shows run for about 2 weeks to 1 month. For most companies, after the run, tapos na. And then after 2 years, copyright goes back to playwright, normally. So if another company wants to do your play, you can negotiate for fee or royalty. However, big companies may insist on retaining their sole right to the play in perpetuity, along with royalty payments per show. It's up to you to decide. Does that pay? Right now, one in-demand playwright may normally be commissioned to write one play every, 6 months to 1 year. Lalo na kung resident playwright siya ng company. And that's a very prolific estimate. That's 2 plays a year, max. Some of them can only do one every 2 years. Imagine, with the current rates, if you write one play a month, you probably survive on writing plays alone. But that's impossible. The most I got to do is 3 to 4 in 1 year. And that's a miraculous year. And a very exhausting one. So I don't think that will ever happen again. Playwright is a profession. I pay taxes. I issue receipts. A poet is not. And I doubt if it ever will be. But dahil profession, automatic na ang success ng profession is measured in pesos. Ganoon lalo sa larangan ng pelikula, television, mainstream media. Kung tumabo ang iyong sinulat, tataas ang market value mo. And how do you reply to the question, who can argue with success? If I rate myself according to these parameters, then talo na ako. I'm trying to recall which of my works ang kumita sa theater man o sa mass media. I don't think I have any that I can rightfully claim. And don't think that I'm being highbrow about this. Manunulat, may mga moto na rin naman akong naibon. Tatlo ibigay ko. Ang isa sa mga nakakatawang moto kapag nagbibigay ko ng writing workshop ay, take the drama out of your life and onto the stage. I use that statement to make the distinction between reality and realism. Pag-alim naman ang konti. What verisimilitude really means. I always assure my students that one doesn't have to experience things one writes about. Kahit pa sabihin the best source or subject of any beginning writer is one's experience. I would rather they develop their capacity for empathy and compassion than have to go through the unnecessary and a lot riskier approach of being your writing subject. Notable quote, a favorite quote, is Picasso. And he said, art is a lie that tells the truth. I use it to explain the meaning and relationship of form and content in any work, with truth reflecting the level of understanding you have as a writer, which is strictly determined by, again, your capacity and depth of understanding. Na pwede mo naman i-develop, halimbawa, sa pagbabasa. Yun ang laging pinupok-pok ni Rene Villanueva sa amin, sa kanyang niyang mga estudyante sa pagsusulat. Read, read, read. Develop a voracious appetite for reading. Ang may dagdag ko na lang siguro is, it also matters what you read, what you deem is worth reading, and of course, how you comprehend whatever it is you're reading. So the truth you arrive at in your art reflects all these. The lying part is the form, the craft, the art that you will have to masterfully employ. The wonderful lies you will tell, kahit alam namin they are lies to begin with, para lang lumitaw ang truth. That's the wonderful contradiction and paradox of art according to Picasso. At ang huling motto ay galing kay Joseph Conrad, you never really finish a work, you simply abandon it. not only does it strike a major chord in the principle of writing and rewriting, alam na naman natin siguro yan eh. Si Shakespeare lang daw yata yung na-chismis na nagsusulot ng walang revisions or everything. But apart from that, the motto also reveals my way of working and the relationship I develop with my works. Some writers cling with utmost intensiveness to what they've written. Ako kasi, I let go. Some writers say, these works of mine, inanganak ko yan. At masakit mag-label. I write, I get involved with the work. I enter into a relationship with it. It becomes emotional at times, but ultimately, pag nagawa ko na, after all the revisions and edits, pag nakikalabas na, I let go of it. I hope that it gets a life of its own with the audience. Kung hindi ako masaya, gagawa ko ng pambal na kapatid, my own version of the work, very much like a director's cut. But the important thing is, I will have to abandon it sooner or later. Maybe after a few or more years, I go back to it. But most of the time, I usually don't go back to my previous works, if only to publish them, siguro. Of course, I weep and I get horrible reviews, but I don't go out of my way to defend my work like a mother hen, ikontalo. I always like to think that my works should be strong enough to defend themselves. And if they don't, then sorry na lang ako. In the same vein, I wash my hands of any responsibility should the work go on its own journey. Once I let go of it, it's yours, as much as it has been mine. In the meantime, I'm off to another start.